Shalom to everyone. We're learning today Zera Shimshon Parashat Naso. Alera Vav, page Kuf Samech. It says in Pasuk, in the Haftarah of Parashat Naso, since the Parasha talks about Nazir, and who was the famous Nazir from the mother's stomach, that was Shimshon HaGibor. As Pasuk says, Vayavo Malach HaElohim Od El Aisha, and again the angel of Hashem came to the woman, Vehi Yoshevet Basadeh, and she was sitting in the field, Umanoach Isha En Ima, and her husband Manoach is not with her. Kashe, it's difficult. Mipnema Ach Av Bapam Hashanit Halach El Aisha. Why even the second time Malach came to woman? Va'alo hi kva shama va'azine kedad malasot. She already heard. She knows already what to do. That she's not allowed to drink wine, eat grapes. For the husband. But she knows what to do, right?
In the womb.
Va'aya lo lelech etzel abav. So you, angel, want husband to keep it, so go to the husband. Why come to the wife? He's not on the same level. And for sure, if he would pray, it would be fulfilled on her. And the answer is why Malach came to her and not to him. The Ita b'Yalkud, it says in Yalkud Shimoni Shoftim, Umar'ehu kemar'eh Malach HaElohim. When she was saying to her husband who came to her, she said his face was like angel of Hashem. They don't know it's an angel who came. Angel came to speak to her.
Looked like a man.
What was her name? It's Lalfonit something.
Who, the lady?
Yeah.
I'll tell you right now.
Umar'ehu kemar'eh Malach HaElohim. And that was his wife. And his image was like an image of angel of God. Kesvurabo Shehu Navi, she thought this guy is a prophet and he looks like an angel, but she doesn't know it is an angel, right? Ve'eno ele malach, but he's an angel, he's not a prophet. Va'kadosh Baruch Hu ratza she'achshavu navi, Hashem wanted that they should think that this is a prophet. Kedei she'achakach ya'atzru le'echol lechem, so later on they should beg him to come and eat from them. If angel would go to the husband, maybe husband will think that this is an angel. And so if he would go to the husband would say this is not a prophet, this is an angel. So in order for him not to be known that he's an angel, he goes to the wife. Angel goes to the wife, so she thinks he's a prophet. Guys, tell me one thing.
Is that proper?
A guest comes to that. That's first thing. Is this proper? Come on. Angel comes to woman that she should think it's a prophet. Why not to the man? Oh, he's gonna know it's an angel. What's the difference? And is this proper at all? What's going on here? וזהו שאמרו זל, and this was our חכמים saying, גמר ברכות, page 61a, ויקום וילך מנוח אחרי אשתו. מנוח got up and he went after his wife, means after her advice. What's the name? I think it's Lalfonit.
That's
Lalfonit. Yeah. ויקום וילך מנוח אחרי אשתו, מנוח went after his wife, אחר דבריה ואחר עצתה, after her words and after her advice. וקשה, and it's difficult. דמי דבריה ומי עצתה. What is her words and what is her advice? איקה הכה, that there is here. ועלו כל מה שעשתה ציווה להם המלאך. Anything she did, commanded angel. He said, Tzlalfonit, go tell your husband to do this, 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 and this. Don't drink wine. Don't eat grapes, because the son will be a Nazir. So Manoach followed his wife's words, and he fulfilled it. So why are you saying it's his wife's words? The words of the angel. It's not his wife's words. אלא ודאי רצו לומר, אחר דבריה, לחשוב אותו לנביא. כמו שחשבה היא, but what it says here after his wife's words means not what to do, but who he is. She said, it's not an angel, it's a prophet. What's the difference? Who cares who he is? She says it's a prophet, he has to believe her. He believes her that he's a prophet. What's the difference if he's an angel? Huh? There's a problem, Lord Baruch Haram? He's an angel or he's a prophet? What's the problem?
Big difference.
Why? Who said big difference?
God.
What's the difference?
God and human.
Angel is God?
God's messenger.
What, prophet's not God's messenger?
It's easier for a woman to say, my rabbi told me so.
Sometimes you can have... Eliyahu HaNavi can come as a homeless person. He can also be disguised. Prophet, disguised angel.
Okay, what's the difference?
There's no difference.
Prophet doesn't walk around
got a
in the field.
To let the message through? Emergency message prophecy? That danger is coming, why not? And if it's true, why she was not thinking that it's a prophet, but it is an angel? Why she said it is a prophet, they say he's an angel, because prophet doesn't come to the fields. ואחר הצטה להזמין אותו לסעוד עמהם. And now, first difference is, if he's a prophet, I could tell him come to my house and eat. If he's an angel, I cannot tell him come to my house and eat. There's no come and eat by angel. Make sense? What's the difference to invite somebody to the house? Come, don't come. Let's eat, let's not eat. What's the difference? וזהו מיתה ומה שכתב הבחיה. And this is what says רבנו בחיה. בפרשת כי תצא. In פרשת כי תצא, ועל דלת המדרש. This is what says in the midrash. שיש מצווה שמתן שכרה אריכות ימים. There's sometimes mitzvah, you get a reward for it, a long life. What usually two mitzvot you get long life for? Respecting parents, you get your long life, and also chasing the bird and taking the egg, taking the baby. There is something compared to that, even though it's not one of these two, also gives you long life. What is that? שיש מצווה שמתן זכרה אריכות ימים כמצוות שלוח הקנו יקיבות אביהם, מצווה like these two, ויש מצווה שמתן זכרה בנים בהכנסת אורחים. Some mitzvot are like that, give you long life, and some mitzvot, if you do, you get children. Which mitzvah is that? Bringing guests to your house. When you bring guests to your house, yes, you're not only having sons, but you also have Talmidei Chachamim. But we'll see how it works. For now, you have sons by bringing guests, not children, sons. You know sons is? Boys. When you bring guests to your house, guest has three conditions. You have to give them eat, you have to give them drink, and you have to escort them.
It could be your own fault.
Guests is people who need to come to Shabbos, not just randomly.
Oh, if you want to have children, Talmid Chachamim, then your guest has to be Talmid Chacham. Why? Right. Because when you feed Talmid Chacham, as if you bring Temidin, Korban Ola. Not Talmid Chacham, you will have sons. But again, huh? Yeah. Haggadah we learn. Halachmania, Helachmania. You call your poor people to your house and you feed them, right? During Gaon Mivilna's time, I don't want to forget the story. There was a rich man, he brought a lot of guests to his house. One day his house was burning. People came to Gaon Mivilna and said, Rebbe, what's going on? This is the mitzvah, this is the reward. Gaon Mivilna said, he did two things out of three. We learn bringing guests to your house from the word Eshel. Achilash Tia Levaya from Avraham Avinu. What he did, he brought guests to the house and made them eat good. Made them drink good. But when they were leaving, he didn't say bye, he didn't escort them to the gate. So when he did only Achilash Tia Alef Shin, Levaya, he took it away. Alef Shin is Esh, fire. This is why he caused fire on himself. So if you want to do a mitzvah, you start and you finish. You don't leave the mitzvah in the middle.
This week I had a family in our house. We had a guest one day. And they were there for like four hours. 4 hours he didn't step to the
Torah. He didn't stop.
Psh. He was like, wow. You know, and not only him, he would make his children do it. He didn't stop. He didn't want to waste time. So if it's a guest like that,
of course.
If you yourself not like that.
It has an upside of it,
Rabbi, what if the guests don't eat?
Huh?
What if the guests don't eat? Do you get a mitzvah for that?
What if the guests don't eat? What's the reason they don't eat?
Wife's not a good cook.
They're not hungry or they don't trust? If you did what you do and your guest doesn't want to eat, he doesn't feel like eating. You try to make sure that you break the shyness, this, that, you know, try to give them food, but it doesn't work, they don't eat for many, I don't know, different reasons. You did your part, what can you do? Can't force something. Okay. ומשום מחי היא נתנה לו עצה להזמין אותו לאכול עמהם. So because by bringing guests to your house you have a baby boy, she wanted to invite him to the house. If he would be known he's malach, she would never want to invite him to the house. Once she doesn't invite him to the house, there's no baby boys. Makes sense? Because he appears like a prophet and not like an angel, you invite to the house and then you get baby boys. משום אחי נתנה לו עצה להזמין אותו לאכול עמהם כדי שיהיה הבן הנולד בשביל זכותם נמי. So she said, when we will have a baby boy, it will be with this zechut that we feed somebody tzaddik, especially like this prophet. ואף הקדוש ברוך הוא רצה כך. דמחשבה טובה הקדוש ברוך הוא מצרפה למעשה. השם can see this good thought as if he did the action. A good positive thought, Hashem can see this as an action. What's considered guest?
Needy people.
Anyone who needs help. Anyone who's he came on Shabbat and he doesn't know where to go. Yeah. And you want to call him for Seuda? Of course. Some parents, they cannot cook.
You're inviting them for Shabbat.
That's also a guest.
But that's not the same type of guest what you're looking for. You're looking to do and actually go out of your way and bring people.
Everybody's different.
It is to put a check in the box, like you sit with your family of Shabbat. 1 week you're here, 1 week you're there. No. That's not really a guest.
In Sovietsky Soyuz, Russia, you're right. In America, every parent wishes to at least see twice or three times a month their child.
Absolutely.
So when you invite your parents, that's achnasa dorchim. You get double mitzvah over there. Spending time with your parents, kibud avim. Lashon Hara. If you bring guests to your house and that's Lashon Hara, then you have to
feeding the purpose.
Make sure that guest doesn't speak Lashon Hara. You don't call guests for Lashon Hara purposes. Then you kill the whole purpose. Mm-hmm. You don't speak Lashon Hara when the guests come. You don't speak Lashon Hara at all. But when you bring a guest, guests speak Lashon Hara. I mean, sorry. Second thing, I'm sorry to say openly, if guest feels comfortable and becomes part of the house, tells you what to do, how to live, how to learn your lifestyle, next time you're not allowed to bring that guest to your house. Many times I heard situations, people came to collect money from various places, and husband said, you know, I'll give you basement, stay as much. He wants to be Hasid guy. Then he comes one day and he sees this guest already stepping where he's not supposed to be stepping and does destructions in the families. This is not a guest and this is wrong. Guest has limits. When a guest feels part of the family, he tells you how to run your life. Atzlacha, bye bye. Don't bring that guest to your house. Why? Why should you have shalom bypass because of the guest? It's very important to know this stuff. Now Moshe Feinstein used to say, guest should be like part of your house, but not more than that. Once he becomes boss in your house, atzlacha rabba. Next, Vatam. And the reason that Hashem didn't want that Manoach should know that this is the angel until the end of the action, if he would know that from beginning, he couldn't have bring Korban Ola. Why not? He wouldn't have bring sacrifice if he would know this is an angel. Why? If you bring sacrifice from the angel, you know what happens? Idol worshipping happens. Mipnei she'enileh she'makriv ha'korban le'malach chas v'shalom. Because it seems as if he's bringing the korban to the angel. Kedamrin ha'chulin dav mem alev amud alev. Gemara chulin page 41a. Look what it says. You think it's easy to be shochet? Not at all. En shochatin le'toch ha'mayim u'ne'arot. You're not allowed to make shechita. Slaughter chicken and spill the blood into the ocean or the river. You know why? People say, ah, he brought sacrifice for the angel of the water. He's bringing sacrifice to the angel of the ocean. The Bishna Mekeshaya Sover Manoach Sheunavi. When he thought the Manoach, when Manoach thought that angel was a prophet, when he said, let me bring in front of you the male goat, he wanted to bring a korban for him. There's no chshad on this. There's no worry. We don't worry that he's doing idol worshiping. So he wants to bring his korban to Hashem in front of the prophet. Why? When you're in need, you go to a big rabbi to pray. Why, you bow down to rabbi? No. You want rabbi Zuchut to raise your tefillah, elevate your tefillah. So same thing, he wants to bring a korban in front of a prophet. So through the prophet Zuchut, tefillah goes up to Shamayim. Levnanu v'kdei sheisayu b'kdushato u'bekavanotau sheyeh l'nachat luach lefnei ha'makom. So with the kedusha, and with the Kavanah, it should be raised to Shaman, to Hashem, with the Zuchut, with the power, with the help of the Malach. But he thought that was a Navi, prophet. If he would know that this is an angel, he would not be able to bring Korban. Then he would be forced to do this korban in front of the angel. So he should be able to take out fire from the rock. Manoach lo hevi esh klal. Manoach did not bring fire. You know, korban, you want your animal to be burnt in front of Hashem? Yeah, burnt offering, right? Olah. So he bring fire. He didn't bring a fire. Why? Because he said with this prophet's power, there's going to be fire. And it depended on the prophet that is going to bring in the fire from the heaven. And this is what happened. As the mafashim write. Guys, it's getting boring?
No.
Do you understand what's going on for now? Fine, Nisim? Everything's normal? Yeah? Eliezer, you with me? Avilan, you with me?
Mm-hmm.
Not boring?
I'm with you.
Let's go. Umikol sheken, ledat kama chachmei ha'emet. According to the chachmei ha'emet. You know what chachmei ha'emet is? People who teach Zohar, Kabbalah. Shimshon haya gilgulo shel Nadav ben Aharon. Shimshon was gilgul of Nadav, son of Aharon HaKohen. Ve'amru zal Rosh Hashanah dav kavhei amud alef. It says in Gemara Rosh Hashanah page 25a. Badan ze Shimshon. Badan. What's Badan? Put the word like this. Would be Nadav. Badan. Vadan. Nadav. Okay? Badan. It's Shimshon. You should know one thing. When your name is Abraham, right? People call you Avrumi, Abi, Abrami, Abrasha, anything like those. You should know. If this nickname sticks with you all the time, look into it. Why? Because nickname to person is given to hint about him something. What did Goliath say when David HaMelech wanted to go fight against him? He said, what am I, a dog to you?
Yeah.
He said that?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
The last one.
His mother lived with the dog.
Last one.
Goliath is a giant.
Mm-hmm.
Shimshon is called Badan. Second name is Badan. You know there are some Bukharan people by the name Bagdan. Mm-hmm. Bagdan means like owner of the field something. Bogdan. Ba'adan and Bagdan, I think it's two different things, no? Ba'adani or Bagdan, that's like owner of the field. Okay, Lamai says, any nickname you have, if this nickname is a positive, you are being carried like with, look into it, because there's no nickname for no reason. Everything has a reason. Ubedan, Ubadan otiyot Nadav, and Badan the letters of Nadav. Ve'Nadav aviv chatu b'ma she'ekribu esh zara. Nadav aviv sinned by bringing the fire that they were not supposed to. Ve'ata shekvar nit'avra ha'isha mishimshon. And now, since Tzalal Fonit got pregnant for Shimshon, she was already pregnant. She was pregnant. כמו שכתבו המפרשים, as מפרשים, זה שבאותו הרגע שבא לה המלאך, at the time when the מלאך came, נקלט הזרע שהיה לה ברחמה. The zera, the seed, in her stomach was there. When angel came, that moment, the seed was collected. To be fertilized, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fertilized. So it was collected to be fertilized. So that was a moment when the angel came, Shimshon's beginning of his creation began.
Mm-hmm.
Beginning of his pregnancy. Nikla daze shayela belachama. Nitgalgela davar letakena kilkul shel nadav. Lakliv ola. Right away, since Nadav's neshama is coming back right now to fix. So right away, the fixing process begins now. He had to bring korban. Did he bring fire? No, why not? He said, I already brought one's fire down. I ruined that fire. Now I'm going to bring fire down to do the prophet, and I'm going to fix whatever I ruined. And he's fixing the neshama of Nadav. Okay? So nitgalgel hadavar letaken hakilkul shel nadav lakriv ola belo esh. Hediot. Without simple person's fire. Ela be'esh min hashamayim davka. So it comes with a fire from Shamayim to fix it. Ulfi derech ze, and well, with this path, you want a pasuk. Im ta'artzenu lo uchal belachmecha. So angel says, if you will force me to eat, I'm not going to eat your bread. What does that mean, your bread? Angel eats any bread? No, say, I'm not going to eat bread at all. What do you mean, your bread? Your bread I'm not going to eat. V'im ola ala Hashem ta'alena. But if you bring first sacrifice to Hashem, then right away I'll eat. from your bread. If you don't bring sacrifice, I'm not gonna eat. You bring sacrifice, I'm gonna eat. What does that mean? The kasha, איך תזק הדעת לחשוב ולומר שמנוח יהיה חפץ להקריב לו עולה ולא להשם? How would I think that Manoach would bring korban to him and not to Hashem? The itzrich lo marim ta'aseh ola. Therefore he says to say, if you bring korban, what did he say? He says, if you bring korban to Hashem, then I will eat. What, I would think he would bring korban to him? No. What does that mean if you bring korban to Hashem? I'll tell you one thing, I agree with you for life. All the cell phones you have to burn in Gehinnom. Mm-hmm. Why? Because when you give shiur on Shabbat, you get 100% attention. Mm-hmm. When there's a during the weekday, you have to make a box in the shul. Before every guy enters, he puts his cell phone in the box. This way you get all the attentions there. You agree with me? Sure. Thank you. Yeah. Hmm? I'm not on that level yet, but soon. Let's go further.
That needs to be done.
You gotta open up the book.
Call me. You gotta get books, yes. Yeah,
books are over there.
Let's go further. Six people. You're the sixth one. I'm seventh. Where's Lomar?
Rabbi, I got it.
The answer is. The Ita b'Midrash Yalkut, it says in Midrash Yalkut, Al Pasuk Ish Elokim Kadosh Hu, Over Aleinu Tamid. Wife says to the husband, this man is holy. He's passing by us always. What does that mean? Kol HaMarech Talmid Chacham Betoch, Beto U'Machilo, whoever brings a Torah scholar to his house, and lets him eat umashkeu. You give him, of course, glatt kosher food, right? You're not gonna bring Talmid Chacham to the house when you don't have glatt kosher food. Always glatt kosher food. Do you know somebody told me recently? I was shocked. On Shavuot. He said, I used to eat in a not glatt kosher place. Every time I eat, I enjoy the shashlik. I enjoy the shish kebab. I come home, my heart hurts, my brain hurts, my stomach hurts. And then he said, I took my workers to Shashlik place and wait. Next day I see, nobody came to work. And I call and start screaming and yelling, why didn't come to work? He says, I can't get up from my bed. I couldn't sleep the whole night, I was throwing up and then food poisoning and this, that. He said, I thought only me is like this. See, everyone's going like this. Guys, when there's no mashgiach, how can you eat there? I'm not saying it's a bad place, just sometimes they don't have meat and they need meat urgent. So they go to Kifud and get meat. Or C-town, or D-town. And you eat that meat. The question is, did the rabbi make proper shechita? Blood came out, lungs were checked, salting, soaking, did it take place? Why are you putting your life in danger? You pay dollar extra for mashgiach, yes. But you know whatever you're eating is checked. It's proper and you healthy.
Nowadays,
Everyone, you could make up any reasons you want. But I'll tell you one thing. When you eat meat that has hashgacha, there's mashgiach behind it, you're more confident that whatever you're putting in your mouth is checked. It comes with security. Okay, let's go further. We have to be finishing soon. Okay. כל המערך תלמיד חכם בתוך ביתו מאכילו משקהו מעלה עליו הכתוב כאילו הקריב תמיד דין. When it says, this man passing by us always means if you bring a Torah scholar to your house. Who is Torah scholar today? Any guy who wears tefillin, puts kippah, wears keep Shabbat, Torah scholar. Bring him to your house. Let him eat. He eats as if you brought sacrifice to God. Baruch Hashem, we don't live in Sovietsky Soyuz today where people are poor. We live in a place where Baruch Hashem, today people have, many times happens from Israel people come, from Brazil people come, from China people come, Jewish people, and they come to Shul Friday, they wait till somebody takes them home. Come up, say, listen, sir, do you want somewhere to eat? Come, eat by us, and then you could go back to wherever you sleep. You understand? Give someone to eat, you have no idea. You know what happened last week? Something unbelievable, 10 days ago. I was in Yeshua, suddenly two rabbis come in. And they speak in Hebrew. And I asked owner of the house, I said, is there any two places for them to sit? He said, sure. As we were sitting, the owner of the house said, these two people my father's neshama sent. It's his father's yahrzeit. I said, wow, thank you that you passed your test. You know, some people just say, get up and leave. They came, he gave them eat, drink. Came out to be one of them has a big issue in Israel. And you know what he said? He had tears in his eyes. This guy like 55 years old. He says, all day I was running around Queens, Brooklyn, Manhattan. I didn't know where is kosher, where is not kosher. I couldn't put nothing in my mouth. He says, I see you guys religious people sitting by the table, so I assumed it's glad. He asked about Simcha Palace. He said, is this place glad? I said, even Lao Tzadke eats here. Then they start eating something and they had like tears. He said, this is my breakfast. It was 9:30 p.m. So this is when you bring a Torah scholar to your house to eat. Sometimes people make you shuls, right? You're making anyway in a glad kosher restaurant. Sure. A poor man comes in and collects tzedakah. Stop, give him one gosh gijah, give him one fish, give him something. You get double mitzvah. Sometimes people come and say, hey, here's $2, don't collect money, get out of here. It's a mistake. Don't do that. It's not a good thing to do. Okay. אם כן אמר המלאך אם תעשה לפני אכילה כדי שיעלו לך לקורבן עולה דהיינו תמידין לא אוכל בלחמך. He said, if you bring to me food, קורבן to me, in front of me, I'm not going to eat it. ואם תלצא זכות תעשה ממש עולה ותעלן להשם כתיקונה. But if you want proper, bring sacrifice to Hashem and I'll eat from that. So he brought sacrifice to Hashem, and then Malach ate. She'az yeh lecha sachar tov, and then says you will have a good fortune. Bottom line, 1 minute we're done. Omnab, tzov pasuk tamua. She'tam ze, shel ki lo yada manoach, en lo kesher klal im rosh ha-pasuk. It says in the end of the pasuk, because Manoach did not know that this is an angel. He brought korban, and he did not know that this is an angel. והיה לו לתת טעם זה בפסוק הקודם כשאמר לו מנוח נעצלה נא אותך ונעשה לפניך גדיזים כי לא ידע מנוח. Say, מנוח wanted to invite him to the house to eat. He didn't know he's an angel. This way I wanted to invite him. But it says, no. How it says over there? מנוח did not know. I'm sorry, he did not know he's an angel, and then he invited him. ויש לומר שאל, דברי המלאך יש להקשות למה אמר לא אוכל בלחמך. We could ask question on the angel, but angel came to him and said, I'm not going to eat from your bread. What does that mean, I'm not going to eat from your bread? It means, שתיבת לחמך מיותרת היא, ועוד, דמשהו בלחמך אני אוכל, אבל בלחם שלי אני אוכל. It's like, seems like your bread I'm not going to eat, but my own bread I would eat. Vaha legaba malach lo shach achila klal. But we know angels never eat. Angels never eat. Not his bread, not your bread. Vayal lomar lo uchal lechem stam. Ve'tu lo. So he could have said, I'm not going to eat bread at all. Mishumachi ba'asov ha'pasuk liten tam leze. Ki lo yada manoach ulchen ha'malach amar belachmecham. Because Manoach did not know that he's an angel, and he invited him to eat. An angel sees that he doesn't know what he said. I'm not going to eat your bread. Why? Angel didn't want to put him in a situation that he will be scared or shocked. So he said, I'm not going to eat your bread, means I'm going to eat my bread as a human. But he didn't want to let him know that he's an angel. כדי שלא ירגיש שהוא מלאך, they should know that he's an angel. הועיל שעדיין היה עומד בפניהם. So bottom line, had to be, Manoach did not know he's an angel. Therefore he invited him to the house. And because he didn't know, and he brought sacrifice to Hashem and he gave him to eat, even the angels do not eat, still Hashem can see it as if he ate, and therefore came out in the world Shimshon HaGibor. Shimshon HaGibor should have been Mashiach, but there was some slight thing happened that Hashem decided he should not be Mashiach. But again, Yaakov Avinu saw in prophecy and he said, even though this guy did not come up to me Mashiach, I will not lose my hope and I will still play. Dishuatcha kiviti Hashem. Hashem, I'll be praying until I see the real Mashiach coming. And Hashem should send Mashiach Be'ezad Hashem and give the refuah shlema to Chol Cholam Yisrael Bichlalam, Ariel Ben Yaakov and his children, grandchildren, Shegadlu Batolam Yisrael Masim Tovim, Moshe families, and also families Issacharov, Shegadlu Batolam Yisrael Masim Tovim, V'cheni Ratzon V'Nomar, Amen.